Hello Andrey, we're finally made it to you. We're currently in Etnomir. Tell us please, what is the agenda for us? Hello, I've been waiting for so long. I've been waiting for you for such a long time. I welcome the kids this way. Well, I'm very happy you've come. And we can show you the motor that drives this huge, unbelievably huge sled. You can see this correlation. This small motor with 3 kilowatt power and 74 newton meters drives this sled. I suppose you have seen that for yourself. Yes, it's cool in fact, because in our video we have already shown the sled in operation. Now it looks even better as I can see. I'll explain what makes it look better. It's done for good reason. Not mere chick. The thing is that the sled is prone to breaking down. Heavy use makes it deteriorate completely. It turns into scrap, and we need to get rid of it and bring a new sled here. What causes it? I mean the vibration load. Very heavy load. Because people come up, for instance the whole family or even two families, and ask to make a ride altogether. They are asking for that. I understand that we're scrubbing the concrete with the suspension mount, and the shock absorbers fail as often as once a week under such operating conditions. But it's really impressive, I'm telling you guys. There is nothing better than Duyunov's motors. They are not affected at all. They are not overheat. There was a speedometer in the sled we had before. We haven't equipped this sled with the speedometer yet, and the temperature was 38 degrees, and the motor temperature was 72 degrees. And it doesn't heat. Can you believe it? It doesn't heat at all. It doesn't break down. I can feel it, it's cold. Nothing happens to it. That's why we have to change the sleds. The new sled was delivered 2 or 3 weeks ago, and the shock absorber is already out of service. Sergey brought a new one today, we will change it tomorrow. And what is the maximum number of people that you managed to ride on this iteration of the sled? I have already told about that. There was the electric transport festival in Tushino. There were demonstration days in Etnomir. Then a company of 10 ladies insisting on riding them together, saying, take us for a ride together, we don't care how you do that. There were 10 people, even a bit more, but they were quite slim. Dancers from Uganda. The ambassador of Uganda visited the place as well. There was an interesting situation. Ambassador of Uganda asked for the sled. I absolutely need this sled delivered to Africa. He left us his email, his contact details, phone number. I tried to show him the motor. I told him, have a look at the motor, it's not about the sled. And he said, I want the sled and that's it. There was an interesting situation when a group of dancers from Uganda, about 15 people, all of them very slim, got on the sled. 15 people! Yes, they were riding scratching the ground, there were sparks. But the sled was riding the whole group. So the motor is that powerful, guys, it's unbelievably powerful. Probably it's time to consider equipping a steam engine with it. I'm not sure, a steam engine is not something new. There are steam engines everywhere. If you visit Spain or Greece, for instance, you will see steam engines, though they are all petrol-powered. That's possible. That's possible. Nowadays, in a lot of countries, petrol motors are banned in coastal areas in the context of the environment protection trend. Probably the 100 model will be capable of driving 3 or 4 wagons. Do you know what Dmitry Duyunov has done? You remember that he rewound a mine steam locomotive, right? It can replace something like 6 regular ones. I think 5, there are 11 left if I'm right. 11? Well, I think if we take a steam train for children, I think it's possible to add 5 or 6 wagons to it. Easy. Easy. It's easy, really easy. But in fact, nowadays, in shopping malls, such vehicles are used. It's part of entertainment, a recreational activity, and you can easily ride people, entertain them. Do you know what is great? I haven't mentioned. DA90S and DA100S motors, there will be 112. All of them are development of ASPP technology Weihai, which means that these models will be produced in China under the license of ASPP Russia. And you know, through my communication with Victor, I'm surprised at what pace China is adopting, not really adopting, but rather asking to implement this technology in China as fast as possible. Because now even the vehicles with no chances other than being kept at the parking lot are put into operation. So simply changing the motor revives huge projects in China. Replacing the motors with the ones based on the technology of ASPP. That's great for us, for the technology right holders. But I think that in Russia, thanks to such enthusiastic people like you, our transport, I mean transport without motors, will get a new lease on life too. Yes, Alexander, thank you. I totally agree, we have a lot of ideas. We visited Dmitry Duyunov for a good reason last time, since we wanted to understand where we should be moving on. It's more than likely that we will develop in this direction, support this idea. Great, Andrey, we have made it here to Etnomir, but you promised to show us something else, something interesting. Tell us please what it is. Yes, we decided not to bring the quadrunner here today. I'll explain why. The speed limits are very strict here. You see, we didn't limit the speed on the first sled we brought here. And it was riding so fast that I got fined twice. The administration doesn't understand that I'm testing motors. For them, the most important thing is providing safety here. And the speed of the sled was so high that it looked shocking here. In order to demonstrate the full potential of the motor, we changed the quadrunner settings, disabled the power limit, and we're going to take a ride now. Not far from here at the special site, where there are less people, and we will show you there how interesting the DA90S motor is on the quadrunner. And while we're going there, have a look at the top view. As if by magic, let the sled travel around Etnomir. People get interested in the motors right after taking a ride on the sled. Ask to give them a link for entering the project. I mean, people are so thrilled by the ride that they get interested what kind of motor is used there in the sled and instantly ask to send them the link to the project. So, my dear friends, our motors here are in huge demand. Sometimes I'm ready. will relocate to the place called Visokoye, not far from the famous Borovsk that you can see right behind my back, just like this beautiful church. In this wonderful town, the famous scientist Tsiolkovsky started his eventful career. And now we will show you the things that are just as out of this world. Fasten the seatbelts and enjoy viewing. After everything you have just done to these vehicles, you absolutely must explain what is going on here. I'll start with expressing my gratitude to Duyunov's project team. Thanks for coming here, viewing, making a judgment, and most importantly, filming the process to show all of this. Well, we have been testing the motors produced by Viktor Arestov using the combined winding technology, DA90S, DA100S. This vehicle has a DA90S motor, and you can see what the performance is. It's excellent solely thanks to the motor. Those of you who know what quadrunners are like, understand only well that it's not an expensive one. It's produced in China, but what we can do with this motor is just cool. I think that Vitaly, the design engineer, will tell us about it now. Explain what makes this vehicle different. Well, it's more powerful than the petrol one. The most important thing is that it's more reliable, because if we take a petrol motor, it means a week of repair work after a couple of hours of service. Well, that's what Chinese quadrunners are like, but this one runs faultlessly with only charging needed. We ride children, and there has been no repair required so far. Vitaly, tell about the ducks. They are very quiet, produce very little noise, people don't get frightened, only if you're sneaking up. What is this? They catch up, ask questions. Ask to stop and explain. Everyone is curious, of course. Vitaly, you are the person who assembled this unit.
Yes.
I've made the speed reducer myself. How difficult is to implement Duyunov's motor for such vehicles? And can any person who bought the motor plus controller kit do that with their own with no assistance? Well, if you make an effort, I suppose the answer is yes. Great. Vitaly is a design engineer. He makes our crazy ideas come true. And the sled design is something developed by this person. The sled is his work. My name is Sergey. Our team got the inspiration for creating the sled from the ancient inventor Emelya, a famous folklore character. So we pondered, if Emelya could ride a sled with the help of a magic pike, why can't we use Duyunov's motors for that? And the sled rode, with no horses. Great. Wait for more inventations from us. Just as crazy as out of this world. Sure, we're looking forward to this. Our shooting day is over. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. And if you did, don't forget to click the bell icon and like button, write a comment to this video, and subscribe to our social media. That's all, see you again. We'll prepare something even more interesting for you.